Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? Yes, you all are excellent and safe at home. Today, we will see the lesson, the same lesson that is Rich for the Top, but second part that is Maria Sharapova. As we have discussed very detailed summary, the same summary was about the Santosh Yadav, that was the part one, and part two is Maria Sharapova. So Maria Sharapova, what is here? The Maria Sharapova has been the brightest star of tennis, brightest star of tennis world. She also became the world's number one ranked player in 2005. In 2005, she was the world ranker, you know, the first rank holder in tennis world. She is a style icon. She was, you know, she is very stylish girl. And she is so beautiful girl, and she has style also. So that's why she is a style icon and famous not only for her movie star look. She is like a movie star, you know. She was so beautiful girl. Looks, but also for her powerful serve. If dear children, if you have not seen the Maria Sharapova's play, go to net and see, you know, serving the badminton player, the players, and this tennis player, the serve, the first ball when they keep, that strike is Maria Sharapova's so best. I used to see her match, so nicely she used to play. So she was beautiful also and very talented, and in the 2005 she was a first rank holder, and she was too young. At the age of 15 to 20 years old, she got this achievement, like Santosh Yadav, as we have learned. Okay, her humble background. Maria Sharapova, we are going to be seeing in summary also. Her humble background and her temporary loneliness. Why the loneliness? That also we'll see. Temporary loneliness made her mentally tough. Mentally, this must be very tough to do all the things, and more determined. Her hard work is always the magic mantra. She always tells, without hard work, nothing is possible. To get success, so she always tells that hard work is a magic mantra. There is no shortcut to get success. There is hard work. So she always tells that hard work is always the magic mantra for success. So that is her story that we are going to be seeing. Now, this is what is the theme of the story? Theme of the story is that Maria Sharapova's mental toughness. Why the mental toughness? Because at the age of 9, she belongs from Russia. And at the age of 9 years old, when she was 9 years, she went to US. I think so, sure, US for training, for the tennis training. So she has to leave her mother at Russia, and she went along with her father. That time she missed her mother a lot. She, 9 years old child, you know, 9 years old child. From that time, she was there with father. Her father was his father, parents, father and mother. Because of some visa restriction, her mother couldn't get visa to go to US, and so she left alone with her father. So that loneliness made her mentally tough. As if the mothers are there, they love us and they do all our work, you know, simple sada sudha work also. The mother, they know my child is there, let me do for her. But mother was not there from the age of 9. That competitive nature, hard work and sacrifice own her number one position. Hard work, any place, any field, if you're going there, you need hard work. Without hard work, you will not get anything. Okay, that is the theme of this part 1 and part 2 also, that I'm reading for you, telling for you position in the world in the women's tennis. Her humble background and her temporary loneliness, that I said, her humble background and her temporary loneliness made her tough. And that the sports person acquire the habit of working hard. Any sports, badminton, tennis, cricket, volleyball, hockey, any sports, you need much hard work day and night, hours and hours, then only you get success. The same thing she also got, and that's why after that she got, you know, the world number one rank in 2005. Once you see her match, you will also fall in love with her. So nice she plays. Okay, so it is the passion and the determination which make them enjoy training and practice they used to do. What is the short summary? The journey to number one. What is the journey to number one? What she has done for this journey in his sports career for to get number one in the rank holder, the top position. So the Maria Sharapova is a Siberian girl. She's Siberian Russian girl who reached the highest platform of women's tennis in the world. Her journey started from the plains of Siberia when she was there. So she started there, and at the age of 9, her competitive world began before she attained of 9 years. She was not 10 years old also, and from that year her journey, the sports journey, the tennis journey started in her life. So she has to leave her parents there, father, mother, and she went to US to do that. And due to her mental toughness, she bagged the ladies single crown at the Wimbledon in the year 2004 and 5. In August 2005, she became the world's number one woman tennis star. Kuch paane ke liye kuch khona padta hai. So what she has lost in the sense, she missed a lot. That kuch khona padta hai, her mother was not there with her, that she was there, that her sacrifice towards determination, towards hard work, she sacrificed her mother was also not with her. That her sacrifice, what was her sacrifice? She had highly competitive desire since her age of 9. Maria Sharapova went to United States for her training. When she had not yet celebrated her 9th birthday, she went there for training. Maria went to Florida. The US, she went in Florida for training in tennis. There she felt lonely. There she felt very lonely. She missed her mother greatly. She could not go with her due to visa problem, visa restriction. Her mother couldn't go with her to Florida. Her father also couldn't see her mother. And see the sacrification of fathers also. She got this achievement because of her parents also. Parents, mother was in one place, the father was in one place, and that father also had completely given her life, you know, to that child. And he was away from her, his wife, means from her mother also. And her hard work. What is her hard work? Maria was very young at the time of her training. She was very young when she was just 9 and 10 years, and her journey started. And she used to sleep early while the other tennis players would come around 11 p.m. for practice, from practice and all. She used to sleep only, but they would make her and tell her to clean the room. This made her mentally tough and strongish. She learned. What she learned? She learned how to take care of herself. As being a girl, mother was not there. So she learned all the things herself with a company of her friend circles also. She never thought of quitting in her life. She did not give up even a single time. She always thinks that quitting up is not in her, it was not in her nature. She always knew that she wanted whatever she used to think, she always get through this her hard work. Love for Russia, even though she has taken completely training in USA, but as being a Russian girl, Siberian girl, so she had love with her country. She tell, I will be very happy to play in Olympic towards my country my side country. This is her love from Russia. Maria speaks the American accent. That's from the age of 9. So she learned all the American accent. But she proudly admits that she is Russian. She says, I am Russian. It is true that US is a big part of my life. US has given me career, but the Russia is also equivalent to that. But I have a Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play Olympic for Russia if they want me. I will play for my Russia if they will allow me, because she has taken all the training in the USA. But if they allow me, if this Russian country, you know, Russia allow me to play for their country, for my country, I will be very happy to play for my Russia. This is the love. This was the love about her country. Now Sharapova, she was a teenage girl, you know, 10, then 13, 14, 15, 16, all that up to 19, teenager girl. As a normal teenager girl, she found of fashion. You know, the young girls, when they go to college, they need like fashion very much. So she was also like that. She was determined everything for her tennis, but simultaneously she was taking care of her fashion and all. That's why she was seeing the style icon. She had style, you know, as a teenager girl, how they have the same thing. She's so beautiful to look like a film star. As a normal teenage girl, she is found fashion, singing and dancing. She loves reading novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. She loves eating pancakes with the chocolates and all. How the young girls like, the same she was also there. Okay, she doesn't want that anybody put her under their supervision. She was a free bird. Her mind was also free. So she always thinks that nobody, she looks straight and answers clearly. She cannot be a pigeon hole. Nobody can hold her according to their will and wish. Her thoughts. What was her thoughts? Her thoughts was there. Maria is a straightforward. Maria Sharapova was a very straightforward player of tennis. She tells that she is competitive. You know, she is competitive and works hard for it. She has talent and a desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice in your life also. If you are ready to do hard work and to sacrifice something from your life, definitely wherever you want to go, definitely you will get the success there, and you will also reach the top of the world, the first ranker in any field, dear children, in any field. That's why they have given these lessons in your 9th standard, so you can think about your goal and go straight forward towards that goal. According to her, money is also a motive. Money, she always tells, money is important. Yes, so that's why she says that she has a readiness to sacrifice. These qualities made her a number one. According to her, money is also a motivation. Once she said, Of course, money is a great motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream that kept me going. Hard work, money, tennis players, they got much money. When they play for their country and when they play for in the Olympics and all, they get much money, especially the tennis player. So that also she the motivation. She said that money also gave me the motivation. And she said that the dream kept me going. Which dream was there? To become a number one, world's number one player. That was her dream, and she did the hard work and she sacrificed everything, and she could reach to the top of that level. So Maria had to stay away, as I said that, okay na? And why did the Maria not realize against the humiliation and hands of other athletes? Why she did that? Maria did not realize that the humiliation at the hands of the other athletes, because she was working hard. She was working day and night, hard work, world's number one, to become a world's number one tennis player. What the actually, you know, the main important role of her parents also are there. When Maria went to US for tennis, she was only 9 years old. So her father accompanied her there and worked hard to keep the tennis training going. So her parents played an important role in her success. So the parents are there, her hard work and her determination and the motivation that's always kept her on the top of that. So here is the short summary of this lesson, that is Reach for the Top Part 2, Maria Sharapova. Dear children, I think so you might have understood this lesson. Read this lesson very clearly and try to understand the complete story. In the next lecture, we will see the detailed explanation of this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.